First of all, I want to welcome our witnesses today, Dr. Chu and the other witnesses. I like the fact that this is an assessment of national energy policies, what we've achieved over the last decades, and what our goals are for the coming decades. The hearing is timely and relevant. One of the most important lessons we've learned about national energy policies is that their key to success is ensuring that they are comprised of comprehensive solutions, solutions for strengthening both our national and economic security. I certainly believe we're thinking comprehensively, Mr. Chairman, when we introduced our National Energy Security Act, which was intended to increase and diversify the supply of domestic energy resources, promote electric and alternative fuel transportation, and strengthen our energy infrastructure. And I was pleased that many of the provisions of our bill were included in the Bingham and Murkowski bill that was passed out of the Energy Committee last year. As you know, we started in 2003 to start doing something about this. Finally, got a bill in 2005, 2007, now 2009. And I would really hope that, in spite of the fact that people are conscientiously working on some kind of a climate bill, that serious consideration be given to the energy bill, which is something on a bipartisan basis that I really think we could actually get done in this session of the Congress. For the last 10 years, I've spent a lot of time as ranking member and chairman of the Environment and Public Works Committee on Nuclear Safety. And the goal was to try and create an environment where we could take advantage of nuclear power. I refer to nuclear power as a threefer. First of all, it's a way of reducing our carbon emissions. Without it, we're not going to be able to provide the base load energy that our country demands. And without it, I think we're missing an amazing opportunity to strengthen our U.S. manufacturing base and create good-paying jobs. It's a part, not the total solution, but it's part of it. And although we've seen some gains, a number of formidable challenges to realizing a renaissance remain, particularly in the areas of regulatory uncertainty, financing, availability of human capital, expansion of the domestic supply chain infrastructure, and used nuclear fuel management. And I believe that solving the challenges are paramount to the safe and secure growth of the U.S. energy sector as a whole, because utilizing nuclear energy is absolutely essential if we're going to harmonize the country's needs for energy security, economic competitiveness, and a healthy environment. So in closing, I must say that the time is of the essence. You're right. The department's had some money through the, what we call that?
The
stimulus bill, yes. And Dr. Chu has and his colleagues have a wonderful opportunity to send us in a new direction, and I'm really anxious to hear what your thoughts are about where we ought to be going.
Senator Voinovich, thank you very much. Senator Feinstein.
Well, Mr. Chairman, I'm an unhappy senator from California, and I